sense. You might have done something with these palettes.
Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel. So as you can tell from the title, today we are reviewing the two new Essence face palettes. I discovered these about a week ago in my local Shoppers Drug Mart. I haven't seen anything about these online. I checked the Essence website, I checked the Shoppers Drug Mart website, I checked Ulta. I can't find any sign of online existence of these. Without any further ado, let's get into my first impression, testing, demo, and overall review of the new face palettes from Essence, the matte bronzing powder palette and the pure nude highlighter palette. So we are going to start off with the matte bronzer palette. I like going in with my bronzer contour. I'm not a huge contour person. I usually just bronze my skin, bronzer, then I go in with highlight, and then I finish my cheeks off with blush. So I don't currently have any cheek product, definition product on my face, so I applied all my other makeup just so that once I finish reviewing these, my makeup will be done. It says that the palette is in the shade 10, Better Than Vacation Tan. These four matte bronzing shades give the skin a healthy tanned complexion. Each shade can be used alone or layered to create your kissed by the sun glow. And then you do get a really good amount of product in here. I can't see anywhere how much is in each individual pans, but it says that altogether there is 1.05 ounces, and then you do get a full-size mirror there, which I absolutely love having mirrors and products like this. Then I don't have to get my big makeup mirror and have to hold that while holding a palette. It's just easier for me, especially with filming. So I'm super, super excited about this. I think I'm going to stick to these two, possibly this one. This one here looks a little bit deep for me. The price of each of these, I believe, was $14.99 Canadian. So it's not super cheap for Essence. To buy both of these together came to $30 Canadian, which is definitely a decent amount to spend on drugstore makeup, but you're not really gonna find a highlighter palette with four different shades in it or a bronzer palette with four different shades in it anywhere else for $14.99. I think they could have priced these at like $10.99 and that would have been a little bit more reasonable. Bringing two products up to the cash at Shoppers Drug Mart and hearing $30.99, I was like, oh, I hope these are good. I hope I can get a good review out of these and that people enjoy it and that I, first and foremost, enjoy the product. So we are going to start off with this lightest shade here. I'm not going to do swatches because I like seeing how product performs on the face. If it performs on the face, I don't care how it swatches. Starting out with the lightest shade to lightly bronze up the skin. This wouldn't bronze most people. This is kind of like Hoola Light range. If you have Hoola Light, this is pretty comparable to what that would be. I'd say like this one here is more regular Hoola, and then this is more Hoola Light. Now I'm going to go in. Ooh, that looks really nice. It's going on very smooth. That's a really nice shade for me, especially on days if I wanted like a little more subtle bronze look. That is a really, really nice shade for me. It's super, super subtle, but I think because I'm so fair, you guys should be able to tell. You can see that line there. I had tried some bronzers from Essence in the past, but I wasn't a huge fan of them. I believe it was the Sun Club Matte Bronzer that I tried, which is the name of this palette, but I found the consistency of that bronzer was totally fine, but I found the coloring to be very, very orange for me, so I ended up decluttering it at some point. I don't have it anymore, but this one and just like the tones overall in this palette I think are really, really nice. Maybe this second lightest one here is a little bit warm, but it's definitely not as warm as that other Essence bronzer that I've tried in the past. So this is how my face is looking with that lightest shade of bronzer. I just did a little on both sides here and then a little bit on my forehead. I'm going to go in now and mix the two medium shades, bronze the rest of my face with this. I'm gonna be more like all over with this one because I was just kind of getting a feel before for the lighter one. So I'm going to, ooh yeah, that's much more dark, much more pigmented, much more warm. Wow, that has a lot of pigment to it. These are very, very pigmented
and they seem to be blending nicely.
All right, so this is how my face is looking with those two medium bronzer shades blended out. I think it's looking a tad warmer than I would like, and I think it was this second lightest shade here. I think if I had just gone in with these two, it would have been a little bit less warm, but that second lightest shade definitely added a lot of warmth to it. That said, it's more warm than I'm used to, but I don't think it's like unflattering or too much. I think with a little bit more blend and like highlight and blush and everything on, it will be very pretty together. I was extremely impressed with the pigmentation, the blendability. It's not like patching at all. I think it looks really, really nice on the skin. I do want to blend it a little more on my forehead. I feel like I have a little bit of that helmet look right now. So I have pulled out my MAC Studio Fix pressed powder. This is in NC15. This is what I use to set my face pretty much always. So I'm going to go into that same Sephora brush and swirl it around. And I'm just going to use that powder to blend the edges of my bronze and make it a little less intense and more muted and more blended. I think it looks really, really nice. The pigmentation is there. The blendability is there. Overall, I think this is worth the money so far. Even if you are light like me and you're only really getting use out of one half, I think it's a really, really nice option and I'm really into it. Now we are going to go in to a highlighter. I don't know if I already said this, but the original Pure Nude Essence highlighter is too dark for me. I did previously purchase it. I tried to wear it for a little while and then I just came to terms that it was too dark for my skin tone because I am very, very fair. I'm like an NC10, NC15 from MAC, so I'm pale, but I think some of these shades will work for me. We have a purpley cool tone like iridescence. We have a lighter traditional gold, a darker traditional gold, and then like a rose gold kind of champagne pop, Becca champagne pop type shade. So I particularly think that these two will work well for me. I can probably get away with the champagne rose gold shade, and then the main gold highlight will probably be too dark for my skin, but I can at least use it as an eyeshadow, multi-purpose it. The packaging on here is the exact same size, same amount of product, same mirror size. This palette is called 10 Highlighter Reload. Get up and glow, inspired by our iconic Pure Nude highlighter. These four shades with incredible payoff and amazingly smooth texture adds a natural luminescence to cheeks. I would have preferred to see like a more white gold highlight instead of the purpley highlight, but we'll see how it works on the face. So I'm going to start out with the lighter gold highlight and I'm going to put that on my cheekbones. And yeah, we'll start it out on my cheekbones just because I don't know which of these will be too dark for my nose and my upper lip. Putting it on to this brush, again, a little bit powdery. Essence, you might have done something with these palettes. That is very pretty. And this one is definitely light enough to have on nose and my Cupid's bow. This one is definitely light enough for that. So I'm going to go ahead and do that. Ooh, I love a good nose highlight. I'm going to go in with this pale lavender pinky shade. I don't love a like colored cool toned highlight. I'm not super into that, but for the sake of this video, I'm going to test it and it might be really gorgeous and look very different than it does in the pan. So I'm picking up a decent amount of that, tapping it off, and then going on top. Oh, you can definitely see a little bit of that pink. That is intense. The back of the palette says that it adds a natural luminescence, which is true, kind of, but I feel like they should advertise this as a highlight and not necessarily like the Pure Nude, more natural lip from within glow, because this can definitely evidently be built up to be a more intense going out beaming from space highlight. If you just put on a little bit, it can be more natural, but you can build it up, and that's what I love in a highlight. I love a good versatile highlight. I like being able to build it as much as I want and then have it more subtle when I don't want as much highlight, which is rarely the case. But I
really, really like the way those two look together, those two shades. They don't look too dark. They don't look too light and icy and stripey. Like, they're blending in to my face really, really nicely. I've already added a decent amount of highlight and I don't really want to add more and ruin it. I'll do a finger swatch of all of them. So those are the shades there. This is the more rose gold shade. This is the lighter gold shade. This is the pinky purple, and then this is the most darkest gold shade. And it looks pretty shitty, to be honest. They don't look like anything special. They look pretty chalky, pretty powdery, but on the skin, I am so impressed with them. I think they're so, so beautiful, and it can be natural, but it can be built up. That is like absolutely what I look for in a highlight. So I'm a big, big fan. I think these are gorgeous. I think the darker shades, I assume, would perform similarly, but obviously my review can only attest for those two lighter shades. And in the bronzer palette, I'm only speaking to the three shades that I did try. And with that nice added touch of blush, that is my completed testing, first impression, demo, and review of the new Essence Face palettes. I think these are great palettes, not only for the price, I think they're just great products. If I tried a product like this from a higher end brand, I would be impressed. The cardboard packaging is like a cheaper product. It's not as glam and high end. The packaging in general is not something to really write home about, but it's functional. I love the mirror and the product works well. That goes for the bronzer palette and for the Pure Nude highlighter palette. Yes, I do wish they were a little more inexpensive just because that's the price tag that I expect from Essence. I don't expect to be spending $30 on two products, but I am getting 8 products for that $30. So I'm glad that I purchased these. I'm glad that it turned out well. That is everything that I have for this video today. Please give it a thumbs up if you did enjoy it. If you aren't already subscribed to me, please be sure to do so. I hope that you had an absolutely awesome day as always, and thank you so, so much for watching. Bye.